40 pounds out of Birmingham, Alabama, Randy Barbour. And his partner at 226 pounds out of New Orleans, Louisiana, Larry Clark. And their opponents, a tremendous new tag team. Introducing first of all at 240 pounds out of Phoenix, Arizona, here's the AWA Wrestler of the Year, Tom Zenk. And his partner out of Robbinsdale, Minnesota, he weighed in at 244 pounds, Curt. Hennig, one for your referee, Jim Mitchell, and out on the ringside, Larry Nelson and Nick Bockwinkel.
Thank you, Ken Resnick. This should shape up to be a goodie. Randy Barbour, a dandy wrestler. He's out of Birmingham with Larry Clark from New Orleans against Curt Hennig and Tom Zenk, a hot new tag team. Nick Bockwinkel, your thoughts?
Well, we'll have to take and wait and see. There's no question Curt Hennig is definitely a veteran. Tom Zenk is more of a rookie, and a rookie, though, that has been very impressive in the past year or so that he's been a professional. And they have excellent credentials. Both of them are about the same size and shape, 235, 240 pounds. Beautiful hip lock executed by Curt Hennig. Curt, of course, second generation like myself, and like a number of sons, brings probably a lot of inherited knowledge to the sport with him.
Curt Hennig starting for the team of Hennig and Zenk. He's in there against Larry Clark. I know nothing about Clark. He's out of New Orleans at 226 pounds. The speed of Curt Hennig always impresses me.
Yes, you saw some great amateur moves there. Curt Hennig was an excellent wrestler in both high school and in college. And that was a nice, he took his man down, and you could just tell by the lightness in which he stayed right on top of his man. It showed his balance and his dexterity for a man of his size.
Now we'll see Tom Zenk. Tom goes 240 pounds out of Phoenix. Clark throws him off. Tom Zenk right back with a shoulder block. Now,
beautiful
Clark.
Reverse hip lock, yes. And an arm drag. Another arm drag. This is one of the things that is a mark of an excellent wrestler, and that is, as someone is, with speed, is trying to apply something to you, you are instantly able to reverse it and bring it around to your advantage.
How about the teamwork here between Tom Zenk and Curt Hennig? Back and forth.
Right there. They're not giving their opponent a chance. And they're setting a very heavy and a very hard pace at this time. Not only are they moving quite fast, but they're working very hard on the mat.
I don't see how Larry Clark has any arm left as he hits the mat. Tom Zenk right on top of him, staying to work on that arm.
Got him in a hammer lock, and he's right there.
The key now for Tom Zenk is to keep his man in the center of the ring and to keep working on the arm.
He's already allowed him to get too close to the other side. In fact, you can almost see a tag. But at the same time, he's got the pressure on that arm, and Clark can probably go where he might want to go, but he's going to do it at the possibility of losing a shoulder or an elbow.
Tom Zenk right back on him, but he let him get away. Clark tags Barbour. Barbour in the ring now. Our first look at him, 240 pounds. He's out of Birmingham. Even weight between Barbour and Tom Zenk.
Barbour is a more experienced man, as you can see. He's going right at Zenk. I mean, he's just not going to waste any time. Breaking the eyes, that makes it very hard to see. Know where exactly where you're at. You're trying. I mean, it's even though your eyes instantly close, the scratches, they burn, and they'll start to water, and this makes it very difficult.
Barbour tags right back out to get Clark in, and then Clark right back to Barbour. Now they're showing us some teamwork. Randy Barbour apparently going to do whatever he has to do to get back into this battle. I call it breaking the rules. You call it smart wrestling.
Well, you know, you've got a four-second count, and that four-second count, what it amounts to is very simply, you can do whatever you like in that 4 seconds. As long as the man doesn't say five, you're not going to be disqualified.
The control right back to Tom Zenk and Curt Hennig. What do we got? Double
dropkick.
That's got to be it for Barbour, but maybe not. Curt Hennig takes him over to his corner and puts one on Larry Clark. Right back to work on Barbour. And again, there's one for Clark.
They're playing a little bit dangerous by taking him and getting that close into the corner there.
I thought they had him with a double drop click.
Well, if you notice, I'm not sure if either man went for a pinfall, so that's an error on their part.
Sends Clark into the ropes. Curt Hennig puts one in the bucket, and down goes Clark.
Right into the breadbasket. That'll take the wind right out of you.
If that didn't, the body slam will. Larry Clark, losing almost all of his animation now, back into the corner with Zenk. There's the tag off. And they're not going to let him go. Let's see what we got here. Beautiful drop kick
right on the chin. Yes.
That's got to do it. No, Larry Clark kicking out of it.
Kind of a takedown. It's a semi-suplex, you might say.
Tried to roll him up, it looked like, but Clark out of it easily. Now he'll back Zenk into his corner. We start all over again with Barbour. And Randy Barbour doesn't mess around. He is here to beat you up. He'll bring Clark in. Not much of a breather. Zenk catches Clark. Barbour out of it. But they're in the Barbour Clark corner. That's got to be bad news for Zenk. That's inexperience.
Yes, it is. I mean, he's finding it out. And but still, at the same time, he's healthy. He's in shape. He should be able to take a pretty good beating. That's one of the things you've got to be able to do.
Resilience is so important in professional wrestling. And now Larry Clark's going to test it on Tom Zenk. But it doesn't look like Clark has a heck of a lot left. They pounded on him for quite some time. He needs to get out of there, let Barbour take over for a while.
You can see where Barbour's got a hold of the trunks of Tom Zenk, not letting him get out of that corner.
Zenk is out of it now. Barbour inexplicably letting loose. There's Curt Hennig waiting for the tag. He got it, he's in, and he's mad. Curt Hennig goes to work on both of them. Clark is down, he's got Barbour, throws Barbour to Zenk. All four men in the ring. What are you going to do? Referee Jimmy Mitchell, you can't control four wrestlers at once. They introduced Clark
very
and
hard,
Barbour.
Right. Actually, the referee, if he would have taken count, he could take and do that. But at the same time, he's got to take and allow the match to go on. He wants to give both these guys as much opportunity as they can. Excellent dropkick of Craven of Curt Hennig's, and this looks like this one will do it.
That had to do it. Curt Hennig loves coming off that rope with that dropkick. He times it very well, and that was the end of it for Larry Clark. Hennig and Zenk over Barbour and Clark. They look good to me, Nick Cognizant.
They do. They need work. They need to smooth out a lot of rough spots that I saw. But at the same time, they're impressive, and they've got the credentials.
Curt Hennig and Tom Zenk. Take it away. Now.
There it is. You see that dropkick. He gets the extra momentum of coming off the second rope. That really knocks a man silly and gets all the extra weight coming down as well.
It's simply a matter of now counting to 3, 4, 5, 10 if you want to. It's over. Hennig pins Clark, your winner. Curt Hennig and Tom Zenk.
All right, Curt Hennig, first of all, you and Tom Zenk, very, very impressive in the ring. Curt, it looks like for all intents and purposes, you've certainly found yourself a whale of a tag team partner.
Well, that's right, Ken. Thank you very much. I'd like to thank Tom Zenk for coming in and being my partner, and I think this is exactly what I needed. Somebody with the same speed, the strength, and also the good looks on this guy. He's going to bring a lot of ladies around to the ring, and I'm looking forward to a lot of big matches with this kid, and he's come a long way, and I'd like to thank him very much for the job that he did out there.
Curt, I've got to ask you, how did you and Tom decide to team up?
Well, you know, Ken, I've been through a lot of things in the last 6 months and year here. All over the world, all over the United States, all these top tag teams. And I believe that Tom Zenk and myself have the ability and the agility and the speed and the strength and the size to get the job done against any two men in Pro Wrestling USA and throughout the world.
All right, well, Tom Zenk, certainly some high praise indeed from your partner, Curt, but well-deserved. Just recently being named, I know you're very pleased, AWA Wrestler of the Year.
Yes, I was. I was very honored, as a matter of fact, and I'm still elated over the fact that, you know, I was chosen of all the top caliber men in the AWA, and I'm just very fortunate to have a partner like Curt to take me on his team, because I've been gone for the last 4 months, traveling all over Canada, from Vancouver, Winnipeg, all throughout the province of Quebec.
Well, now, Tom, while you were gone, we certainly heard a lot about you, wrestling writers talking about you, the tremendous strides you've made, and you, I understand, worked up quite an impressive string of victories in Canada.
Well, thank you, Ken. I did do fairly well, as good as can be expected. There's a lot of top-name contenders up there, such as Dino Bravo, King Tonga, the Tonga Kid, the Wild Samoans. So the competition was very, very rigid up in Canada, to say the least.
All right, now, Tom, I've got to ask you, Curt alluded to it, certainly a very handsome young man, tremendous physique. I'm sure all our female wrestling fans are wondering your marital status.
Well, I'm single, And I got to attribute my looks, I guess, to my folks.
Okay, now, Curt, and I do want to mention you've been gone for a while. I understand there's somewhat of a new career blossom these past few weeks out in Hollywood.
Well, that's a possibility. That's right. I was involved with a movie out in Hollywood. It was called The Bad Guys, and it was about wrestling, and the fact that I was chosen to go participate in that was a great honor for me, and who knows, maybe there will be another career. But right now, I'm back with Pro Wrestling USA. I'm with Tom Zenk. And we got plans to go to the top, so Tom, let's do it.
That's right.
All right, wrestling fans, remember, Tom Zenk, Curt Hennig, what a tag team they are.
Rivalry first.